Hello students, today I'll explain the final accounts of sole trading concern in detail. Before knowing how to prepare the final accounts, let me explain what is sole trading concern is. Sole trading concern is one form of the business which is owned, managed and controlled by an individual person. That person is called a sole trader or sole proprietor. This sole trader is going to make the investment in the business, bears all kinds of risks which are associated with the business and controls the business by himself. His powers are unlimited and his decisions are final in performing the day-to-day business activities. Finally, he is the person who enjoys the profits arising from the business, and at the same time, in case of loss, he has to bear all such losses. Now let us see what is final accounts. So final accounts is an account or statement which is usually prepared at the end of the fiscal period, means at the end of the accounting period. It may be for 3 months or it may be for 6 months or at the end of 1 year. This final accounts mainly aims at fulfilling the two important objectives. The first objective is to ascertain the profit or loss of a business, and the second objective is to ascertain the financial position of the business. Usually every businessman is very much curious to know the profit that he has earned during the year. For that purpose, we are going to prepare the final accounts, and at the same time he is very much eager to know the value of the assets and liabilities as on the closing date. This is why he is going to prepare the final accounts. This final accounts is divided into the three important components or three important parts, such as first one is the trading account, second one is the profit and loss account, and third one is the balance sheet. Let us discuss each of them in detail. So trading account. Trading means it's a process of buying and selling of goods. Account means recording the business transaction. Then trading account means it's a process of recording each and every transactions related to the buying and selling of goods. In other words, in the process of trading, whatever we are spending on purchases and whatever we are earning from the sale of the goods are brought into one account. That account is called as trading account. At this stage, either we get the gross profit or gross loss, which is finally transferred to profit and loss account. The main intention to preparing the trading account is to ascertain the gross profit or gross loss. Dear students, please do remember that the result of trading account act as an important indicator of business efficiency. Now let us see the format of the trading account. Trading account has two sides, debit side and credit side. Debit side with two columns, particulars amount, and credit side with two columns, particulars amount. The result of the trading account is gross profit or gross loss. Dear students, in trading account, compulsorily you get 5 important transactions. I am repeating, you will get 5 important transactions. The first one is the opening stock. Second one is purchases, third one is sales, fourth one is closing stock, and fifth one is direct expenses. So, opening stock. The entry is to opening stock, which is to be taken on the debit side. Opening stock is the stock with which we begin the year, or the unsold goods of the previous year is treated as opening stock for the current year. There is a first transaction, and the second one is purchases. So during the year, if you have purchased the goods, then the value of such purchases are entered in the inner column. Then you have to check whether any purchase returns given in the problem. If so, deduct the purchase returns from the total purchases. Means after purchasing the goods, you might have returned the goods due to various reasons such as damages or defectives in the goods. So if any such purchase returns is given, then deduct it from the total value of the purchases, and balance amount is entered in the amount column. That is the second transaction. And the third transaction is sales. So the entry for the sales is buy sales on the credit side. So during the year, when the goods are sold, the same value of the sales to be entered in the inner column. And from the total value, if there is any sales returns given in the problem, then you are supposed to deduct it from the total sales. And the balance is entered on the amount column. Next one is a closing stock. So closing stock, once again, it is entered on the credit side. It is nothing but left out stock. means unsold stock of the current year, it is treated as a closing stock. Let me explain this with an example. Suppose I'm running a business of buying and selling of televisions. The opening stock is 50 televisions, means in the beginning of the year. And during the year, I have purchased 100 televisions. So total televisions in hand is 150. Out of 150, I have sold 125 televisions. Means remaining 25 televisions is a closing stock. Means unsold televisions is treated as a closing stock. But in trading account, you are supposed to enter the value and not the quantity. So that is all about the closing stock. And the last very important transaction is a direct expenses. So direct expenses is taken on the debit side. The entry is to direct expenses. So before taking all the expenses which are covered under this transaction, first you have to find identify all the all expenses given in the problem. Then divide this that expenses into two divisions, means direct expenses and indirect expenses. Direct expenses are those expenses which are directly related with the goods, means purchasing of the goods or manufacturing of the goods. Say for example, any wages paid to the laborers who are directly involved in the production activity, or any manufacturing expenses paid, or any transportation expenses incurred at the time of purchasing of the goods, or any kinds of taxes paid at the time of purchasing. It may be the import duty or excise duty, or freight charges, octroi. All such expenses are covered under one category, that is a direct expenses. Along with that, any carriage inwards given in the problem, it has to be taken under the direct expenses. In case of carriage outward, it is taken in the profit and loss account. Carriage outwards is related to selling expenses, whereas carriage inwards is related to purchasing of the goods. So after entering all the five transactions, the very important step is to ascertain the gross profit or gross loss. How to ascertain the gross profit or gross loss? In order to know the gross profit or gross loss, we have to take the balance, means we have to balance the trading account. Means we have to take the total of both the sides. Say for example, the total of the credit side is 1 lakh, whereas the total of the debit side is just 80,000. At that time, the higher side total is taken on both the sides. Means credit side total rupees 1 lakh is also entered on the debit side. So after that, the balancing figures comes in the debit side, because the debit side total is just 80,000. So at that time, when the credit side is more than the debit side, the result is gross profit. When the debit side is more than the credit side, then the result is gross loss. Means 1 lakh is the total of the credit side, whereas the total of the debit side is just 80,000. Means 20,000 is the gross profit. That gross profit is transferred to next account, that is a profit and loss account. In the same manner, if debit side is more than the credit side, then it's a gross loss. Once again, it is transferred to profit and loss account. So this is all about the trading account. Thank you.